At this time, it's my pleasure to introduce Ms. Ashley Alva, a master's candidate in biomedical engineering who will give us our reflection. Ashley.
So here we are, graduating from a school that discovered water on Mars and also discovered that all mammals take the same amount of time to pee. Today you're graduating from the Georgia Institute of Technology, a school where every idea can become a reality with only passion as a cost to achieve it. With such a precious degree, you will land an amazing job if you haven't already, or perhaps go back to grad school for even more degrees. Because what is overachieving? And this is possible because you know what it is to ace that midterm by day and submit a paper to a renowned journal by night. Because you know what it is to be addicted to that feeling of success. And finally, because you are one hell of an engineer. The attitude of being the best was ingrained in you the day you came to tech. Today, I'm not here to repeat what you already know about yourself. However, there is something a lot of us overlook about work: happiness. The struggle to be the best becomes so much easier when you're doing what makes you happy. This thought became very evident at tech, when our theses or projects actually mattered to us and made us proud and happy to be working on. All-nighters in the lab suddenly became appealing. Poster presentations suddenly became exciting, and vending machine food actually tasted good. It is so easy to feel depressed and lost when the results of a simulation that you worked on for an entire month are not what you expected. That is when taking ownership of your work and forming an emotional connection really helps. As soon as you forge that emotional connection, work stops being merely work. Every aspect tends to become a source of happiness. Repeating my simulation for 30 more days did not seem cumbersome anymore, because I know that the results, whenever they came, would make a difference, and that makes me happy. Emotion, I learned, is a very powerful yet underrated motivator. So what is common to people like the Wright brothers, Steve Jobs, or Malala? They are people that have created something of value from a place of pure joy. They pursued what mattered to them, what motivated them, and what kept them awake at night. And boy, what a difference they made. And we, as Yellow Jackets, have been cut out to make that sort of a difference. We are not built for a life where we can come back from work at 5, pop a soda, watch TV. No, we are made to always ponder on creating the next. We are made to create ripples of change wherever we go, which might affect one person, or 100, or 1,000,000. All that matters while we strive to create these ripples is that we never let failure deter us. And failure will never deter us if we are emotionally connected to our work. So my exceptional fellow graduates, let us storm out there, elevated by our Georgia Tech pride, and make one hell of a difference. Congratulations.